Hello Facebookers people, I'm Konstantinos and today I'm going to explain to you why relaunches are very important, especially in new ad accounts with new pixels. So, new ad accounts, a new pixel, this means that you have instability. This means that when you're running ads, even if you find success, then your campaign is dying fast. We all know that, we all have experienced it with new ad accounts and new pixels. What is the solution though? The solution is not try to reinvent the wheel. The solution is not trying to always push new creatives and everything. You can do that, but at the same time, you can actually utilize whatever you have seen that it was working before. That means, if one campaign is working and it's dying, then you are relaunching it. You optimize it all over again. If it's dying again, you optimize it. You are going to have results like this and you're going to start having sales coming into your funnel. It doesn't mean that you just abandon something that worked and then don't use it all over again. I have seen this mistake several times. I have one other account right now, which it's working like this and we're trying to train the pixel like this. It's a new ad account. It's actually a baby store from the mother brand that I'm working with, a new project that they have, so I'm helping them with that. And let's go on my PC to show you how it's working. And I will see you there. So, as I said in another video, the February was a very good month. And then March came, which was a much slower month. And guess what is happening? The smaller ad accounts are going to be affected more compared to the ones that are spending a lot of money and they have trained pixels. Now, in this situation, I would like to show you that between 20 and 28 February, in this small brand that we're just starting now to generate pixel, as you can see, we just have a small retargeting here and just a small cold traffic ad. We were having two ROAS, which is exceptionally well for this account because we're going to even operate with one ROAS if we have consistent sales because we train the pixel. This is a company that has a lot of money. They want to go through that process so that they can train the pixel. If you go from 1 to 6, for example, in March, we can see that this one is dropping immediately to 1.32. What are you going to do in that case? Let's say that you don't have their means of doing more creatives or whatever, and you need time, maybe you need 15 days. It doesn't mean that you have to stop your ads for 15 days until you start. It doesn't mean that you have to wait for this one to recover, especially with a new pixel. What you can do is you can come and you can relaunch it. And if we see, I started this one on 11, and the moment, let's go on the 9th, for example, zero sales over here, okay? So it started dying. 8th, nothing. On the 10th, nothing, which is the day that I actually closed it. On the 6th, nothing. So it's having a very bad time. So if we take it from the 4th to 9th, boom, it's on 0.78. If we go even 6 to 9, I guess it's nothing. It's 0.4. So in this specific campaign, we could see that the trend was there and it was slowing, going down and down and down. So in order to protect the profitability, we had to close it. And instead of waiting for new creatives or whatever, I just did a relaunch. What does relaunch mean? Let's do one relaunch together. Let's say that you duplicate this one as a campaign as it is. In this specific situation, I'm using stacked lookalikes. Of course, you're going to open it. You're going to keep it as this. You can name it relaunch 2, relaunch 3, relaunch 4, it doesn't matter. You can come here, you can turn on all of them so that you can start optimizing them. This is a crazy method with stacked lookalikes. And you're going to set it up for the next day at 6 a.m. Right? And that's it. You hit the publish and boom, you have it. This is how you do a relaunch. You are not just going and closing the campaign and open it again. You just duplicate it so that it can start with a new ID and you can start optimizing it all over again. Let me discard this draft so that we can work freely. And now if we go here on the 10th, I believe is when the other ad has started. No, on the 11th, on the 10th, we created it. You can see that immediately the next day, this ad has 2.71 because it's a fresh ad. Facebook is giving to this pixel sales so that it can start getting sales and to continue to optimize with that. And of course, because it's a difficult month, we can see on the 12th it's dropping back to stupid numbers, 1.26. On the 14th, 0.7. At this point, I don't care about this brand because I care about having consistent sales every day. I want my pixel to gather the data and the sale every day. Eventually, I will go to the ROAS part, but this is not the ROAS part yet. This is the part that I'm actually training my pixel. And today on the 15th, I'm having 4 ROAS, but who knows how much is going to drop until the end of the day because it's only 32 spent. So now the last 7 days I'm on 1.2, but it's nothing compared to the other one that for 3 consistent days I didn't have a sale. That means that the duplication and the relance method is working flawlessly. I totally suggest it to you. Look how it's operating in a new untrained pixel account, because you know, marketeers like me, we always show good accounts and everything, and people like you, they come and say, but I'm having a new account, I'm having a new pixel, is it going to work for me? There you go, it's working either on smaller accounts, and it doesn't mean that you need a trained pixel in order to do relances and it's going to work. It makes total sense. It's a new pixel, it's not able to keep the data so that it can continue optimize or target efficiently, or has a lot of data as a pixel in order to know the ideal avatar of the clients. And this is why from time to time it's going to lose the whole optimization. Also, we're going through a tough month, so the weaker pixels are going to be affected more. This means that you can start all over again the next day at 6 a.m. because Facebook is favoring a lot the first 24 and 48 hours of our ads, and it's giving sales so that they can continue having more and more and more sales after that because of the data that they're going to acquire from the sales of the first 24 and 48 hours. I hope that it makes sense. I hope that it helped you. It's not something super advanced. It's something basic, but from my experience and by watching people, I know that a lot of people, they just close an ad and they don't even bother with it again. And it doesn't make any sense. What I note is that the more you do that, the more this ad set is going to die faster eventually, unless if you have a trained pixel, which you can do it infinitely. But with a new pixel, the more you do it, the more it's going to die, but it's going to give you some time at least of consistent sales or some good draws for some days in order for you to be able to go with new creatives and refresh it, maybe new targeting, maybe new strategies, and test something new. So whatever is working, relaunch it, and I will see you for the closing of the video. So, Facebook ads can be simple, Facebook ads can be also complex, but in this case they are simple. And in your ad accounts, you don't need very, you know, big methods or complex structures or stuff. You need stability. And in order for you to get stability, you need to have sales. If that means that you have to relaunch your ads every 2-3 days just to refresh them and try to optimize them all over again and maybe be happy one day when you're going to be able to optimize for a longer period, then do it. It's all about data at this point, and it's all about training your pixel or API. Now, if you want to learn more, you can check my book, my free course or my paid course, and don't forget that you can also check my website. And until we meet again, guys, be creative and be consistent.